Yesterday I had given some problems. You have done?
Yes, ma'am.
Got?
Yes, ma'am. Got.
Same thing. Solution I had given before.
What, ma'am?
Solution I had given. Understood how to do?
Yes, ma'am.
Next topic: computational efficiency of FFT over DFT. Okay. So, how efficient is fast Fourier transform? We have seen methods like previous module. What we have done? It was direct computation. So that one is fine, or this one is? Which one is more efficient? Which one is more time saving? So when you go for direct computation, so number of complex addition is n into n minus 1. So when you go for number of complex multiplications, that is n square. So for direct computation, these are the formulas. When for radix 2 FFT, number of complex addition is n log base 2 n. Okay. And number of complex multiplication will be n by 2 log base 2 n. So percentage saving in addition, how much percentage is being saved when you are doing addition, is given by 100 minus number of addition in FFT divided by number of addition in DFT into 100. The same thing comes for multiplication also. 100 minus number of multiplication in FFT divided by number of multiplication in DFT into 100. So for example, if your number of sample increases, which one is more efficient? So if suppose your number of samples n is equal to 1024, that is 1024. So when you go for direct computation, many additions will get involved and many multiplications will get involved. That is complex addition and complex multiplication. So for that, how much additions is been involved in that? That is n into n minus 1. So you will get so many additions in the same way. Multiplication is nothing but n square. We have seen that formulas. So you'll be having so much. So when it is direct computation, addition, so many will be required. When it is multiplication, so many will be required. For it is direct computation, what you have seen in previous problem, previous module, that is first module. Coming to the radix 2 FFT. So number of complex addition is n log base 2 n. So that is nothing but ln 1024, 1024 divided by ln 2. So many additions is required. And when you come for multiplication, it is n by 2 log n base 2. So how much it is? It is 5120. So when you compare using direct computation, see the addition and see the multiplication. And even here, it is reduced. So which one will be more efficient? So let us see that. So percentage saving in addition, that is 100 minus 1020, that is what numbers we have got, into 100 we will get 99%. And percentage saving in multiplication, again it is the same thing, 99.5%. So using FFT, we are saving additions and multiplications. So the efficiency also increases, whereas the time or the complex addition required and complex multiplication required gets reduced. Next, coming to the problems. So now find the 8-point DFT. Yesterday's class we have seen 4-point DFT. Now find the 8-point DFT of the sequence x of n 1 1 1. They have given the sequence, that is number of samples. They have given 8 samples using DIT, that is decimation in time FFT radix 2 algorithm, using the butterfly diagram given here, given in this figure. So this is a plus b wn to the power of r. This is a minus b wn to the power of r. So what are the trivial factors? That is w of 0, w to the power of 1, w to the power of 2. This we know how to calculate. okay? So W8 to the power of 4, W8 to the power of 5, W8 to the power of 6, and W8 to the power of 7. So now it is 8 point. So how many stages you will have? You will be having 3 stages. So first stage, 2 point you will get. The next stage will be the 4 point. And the last stage will be the 8 point. Here, the flow diagram. This is your 2 point, then later 4 point. Then 8 point. So you are having altogether 3 stages. So accordingly, the same thing what I have explained here, if this is x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, accordingly this will change. That is bit reversal. So if you want, you can remember according to the bit reversal, or else what you can do is you can remember this also. X of 0, even first 4 will get even, then odd next 4 we will get. Okay, so x of 0, x of 2. Okay, so x of 4, x of 6, like this also if you want, you can remember. So accordingly, we will place the data what has been given. So what they have given, it is, so this one will be your x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, x of 4, x of 5, x of 6, and x of 7. Okay, so accordingly, we will write here. So what is x of 0, what is x of 4, x of 2, x of 6. Here again it will be x of 1, x of 3, x of 5, and x of 7. So accordingly we will write all our data. And here, so we will be getting x1 of 0, x1 of 1, okay, x1 of 2. This one will be same thing, x1 of 2, x1 of 3, first stage. Then the second stage, x2 of 0, x2 of 1, x2 of 2, x2 of 3, x2 of 4, like this, till x2 of 7. Then this one will be your third stage, that is x3 of 0, x3 of 1, x3 of 2, x3 of 3, x3 of 4. The x of k will be again x of 0, x of k. This is the third stage. So this is first, this is second, and this is third stage. So accordingly we have written now. So now x1 of 0, x1 of 0 is what? A plus b wn to the power of r, correct? A plus b wn to the power of r. So A is what? 1. And what is this? 0. 0 into 1, again it will be 0. So what we will be getting here? It is 1. But see here, A plus B, Wn to the power of R. Wn to the power of R is what? Wa to the power of 0. So what we will be getting? 1. In the same way, what is x1 of 1? X1 of 1, that is A. Okay. So 0 into 1, again it will be 0, minus. So what it is? Again it is 1. See here. A minus B into Wn to the power of R. So what you'll be getting? You'll be getting 1. Understood? Next. Again here what it is? It is A plus B Wn to the power of R. So A is what? 1. Again here it is 0, so you will be getting 1. Here again it is A minus B, Wn to the power of R. Again it is here what you will be getting? It is 1. Same thing here, A plus B, Wn to the power of R. Here at this point it is A minus B, Wn to the power of R. Okay. Here again it is A. A is what? 1. B is what? 0. So here again you will be getting 1. Okay. Here again what it is? A. This one it will be your A. And this one will be your B. So A minus B, Wn to the power of R. Okay. Even from the diagram also, you can see and you can write. Or you can remember the formula. Got understood? So this you will be having the first stage. So what will be your second stage? Second stage will be a 4 point. So four lines I'll take. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. I'll draw from 1 to third line. Like this cross mark. So here I'll be getting A plus B Wn to the power of R. Here what I'll be getting? A minus B Wn to the power of R. Okay. So X2 of 0, X2 of 2 I got. Next I'll put a cross line like this. Okay. So here what I will be getting? A plus B Wn to the power of R. Here what I'll be getting? A minus B Wn to the power of R. Since it is 4 point, you can write W4 to the power of 0, W4 to the power of 1. Okay, so W4 to the power of 0 and W8 to the power of 0 is one and the same thing. W4 to the power of 1 and W4 to the power of 2 is also, W8 to the power of 2 is also 1 and the same thing. Okay. We have calculated that. So accordingly, we will do and we will see. What is X2 of 0? X2 of 0 is A plus B Wn to the power of R. That is nothing but W8 to the power of 0. That is 2. In the same way, A minus B Wn to the power of R. That is X2 of 2. So 1 minus W8 to the power of 0 into 1, that is nothing but 0. Okay. So in the same way, I'll put a line like this. Okay. Second and third line. So what here it is, A plus B, Wn to the power of R. You can see this. A plus B, Wn to the power of R. You have to practice only then you will be getting this. This is very easy. Okay. Here what you will be getting, A minus B, Wn to the power of R. So here accordingly what I'll be getting, 1 minus j, and here what we'll be getting, 1 plus j. Got understood? Understood everyone?
Yes ma'am.
Same way. Here, that is first to third line. Again, first to third line. So, here what we'll be getting, A plus B Wn to the power of R. Here we'll be getting A minus B Wn to the power of R. Same thing, W4 to the power of 0, W4 to the power of 1. So W4 to the power of 0 is nothing but W8 to the power of 0. W4 to the power of 1 is same thing as W8 to the power of 2. Okay. So accordingly, we will write the solutions. So this will be your second stage. So what will be your third stage? It is 8 point. So 8 points, so all the 8 lines will be there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So first put a diagonal line to the fifth one. Okay. So from here again like this. So here what you'll be having, A plus B Wn to the power of R. Here what you'll be having, A minus B Wn to the power of R. Okay. In the same way, second and 6. Okay, second and 6 you'll be having. Here again you'll be having A plus B Wn to the power of R. Here you'll be having A minus B Wn to the power of R. Okay, again third and 7th one. Third and 7th. Here what you'll be having, A plus B Wn to the power of R. In the same way, what you'll be having here, A plus B Wn to the power of minus R. A minus B Wn to the power of R. Okay, again the fourth and the last one. Here you'll be having A plus B Wn to the power of R. This one, A plus B Wn to the power of R. Here at the last you'll be having A minus B Wn to the power of R. The corresponding formulas is being given here. The third stage. Okay. This is symmetry property also, you can see here. Okay, that is, this is 8 point. So leaving the fourth one, n by 2, that is, you when you leave this one, 3 and 5 will be symmetry, conjugate symmetry it is. Like this is 1 minus j, so this one will be 1 plus j. Okay, again, 2 and 6 will be conjugate. Okay, 0, 0, same thing. Again, 3 and 7, okay, 3 and 7 will be same. With complex conjugate, that is, if this is minus, this one will be plus. That is, symmetry property is also satisfied. Understood? Understood? Any doubts? Any doubts? Kirti, Rajni?
No ma'am, no doubts.
Understood ma'am.
Seema, today you have come, yesterday's class you were absent. See, if you are regular to classes only then you will be able to understand. Rajahalli?
Yes, ma'am.
Yesterday you were absent, right?
Video nodidini.
Video nodira. Artha aita?
Practice madbeku.
See, this is easy as well as it is important. So you can easily score 20 marks in this module. It is short, it is not lengthy also as the previous module. It is very short module, smaller one. But the thing is, you should be able to do nicely, very easily. You can do this one. So 20 marks you can score easily in this. When you compare to the first module, second module is easy. So next problem will go. Will you do and tell me this one? Find the 8-point DFT of the sequence using DIT FFT Radix 2 algorithm. At least 2-point you will try and tell. Same thing like this it is. Little bit butterfly diagram they have changed. A plus B Wn to the power of R, A minus B Wn to the power of R. It is one and the same thing. Okay. So W8 to the power of 0, all these things you all know this. See, like this you will get the diagram. So again, this is your first stage, this is your second stage, and this one will be your third stage. Okay. So here it is A plus B Wn to the power of R. Here again it is A minus B Wn to the power of R. Same thing. A plus B Wn to the power of R. A minus B Wn to the power of R. Okay, this is 2-point. Again, next will be a 4-point. Again, next will be your 8-point. So in the 4-point, two twiddle factors you will get, that is W4 to the power of 0 and W4 to the power of 1. You all try this one. We'll go for the next problem. Compute the 4-point DFT of the sequence x of n is equal to 1010 using DIT FFT Radix 2 algorithm. Find x of n for x of k, found in part A by two different methods. This we have done in yesterday's class 4-point DFT. We have found out using Radix 2 algorithm. Yes or no? So this we have done. Till here we have got this one. So x of k. So DFT is being found out. So x of k is equal to 2020. We have done this in the previous class. This is 2-point. The second stage will be the 4-point. Since it is only number of samples 4 they have given, it is 4-point DFT. Okay. So now what they have told, what is the question? Read out the question once again. So first one we have done already. We have found out what is DFT. Next, what they have told? Find x of n for x of k found in part A. That is IDFT we have to do by two different methods. So what is that the formula? It is nothing but x of n is equal to 1 by n summation k is equal to 0 n minus 1. For this again we have to find out the IDFT, that is x of n. So k is equal to 0 n minus 1 x of k Wn to the power of minus kn. Okay, so here we will multiply, that is 1 by n to find out the IDFT. We will multiply with 1 by n. N is what here? It is 1 by 4. Okay. So here what changes? It is W2 to the power of minus 0. Okay. W2 to the power of minus 0. Here it is what? W4 to the power of minus 0. W4 to the power of minus 1. Only this twiddle factor will change. Remaining remains the same thing. Okay. So after doing what you'll be getting? You'll be getting the same x of n, that is 1010. That is, this is one method. Okay. So the other method. to take conjugate on both the sides, that is x conjugate of n is equal to 1 by n summation k is equal to 0 n minus 1 x conjugate of k, so minus will become plus, so wn to the power of kn. This is nothing but dft of x conjugate of k, so that is nothing but 1 by n y of n, where again x of n will be what, 1 by n y conjugate of n. So we dft of x conjugate of k, so we will take conjugate here. Okay, so when we take the conjugate, since it is wn to the power of kn only, so w2 to the power of 0, w2 to the power of 0, so here w4 to the power of 0, w4 to the power of 1, so what we got, it is 4 0 4 0. So when you divide it by 1 by 4, it is being given here 1 by n into y conjugate of n. So what you'll be getting? You'll be getting 1 0 1 0. That is nothing but your x of n. So any one method you can see. Now, given the sequence x1 of n and x2 of n below, compute the circular convolution x1 of n circular convoluted x2 of n for n is equal to 4. Use DIT FFT algorithm. They have given here x1 of n, they have given x2 of n. So x1 of n is what? It is at 0, it is 2, at 1, it is 1, at 2, it is 1, at 3, it is 2. So what is the sequence? 2, 1, 1, 2 for x1 of n. What is the sequence for x2 of n? It is 1, minus 1, minus 1, it is 1. Okay. Circular convolution, what you have to do, you have to find x1 of k, you have to find x2 of k, then multiply. Okay, so that one will be your circular convolution. Take the IDFT, okay, then you will be getting the circular convolution. So for that, what we have to do, we have to find out first x1 of k, the same method, a plus b wn to the power of r, a minus b wn to the power of r. So using DIT FFT method, so doing here, you'll be getting x1 of k. Okay, so next what you have to do, you have to find out x2 of k. So what is the sequence they are given? 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. So for this, what you'll be doing, you'll be finding out x2 of k. So if x2 of k, after doing, what you'll do, you'll multiply those two things. Okay, this method you'll be getting your x2 of k. Okay, so after getting x2 of k, what you will do, you will multiply x1 of k and x2 of k. So that is what the resultant, it is y of k. So now what you have to do, you have to take the IDFT. When you take the IDFT, you will be getting y of n, that is nothing but the circular convolution. Okay, so y of k. So here y of 0, y of 2, y of 1 and y of 3. So IDFT means here you will be having minus w2 to the power of minus 0, w4 to the power of minus 0, w2 to the power of minus 0. So here what it is, w4 to the power of minus 0, w4 to the power of minus 1. And at last what you'll be doing, you'll be multiplying by 1 by n. Okay. So like this, what you'll be getting, you'll be getting the y of n, that is circular convolution of x1 of n and x2 of n. Got understood? You all know the circular convolution, what you have to do, you have to do DFT of the first sequence, DFT of the second sequence, multiply those two and then do the IDFT. So using this method, we have find out x1 of k, then x2 of k, then we have multiplied, and the resultant what we have got, we have taken the IDFT of this one. So the resultant what it is? It is the circular convolution of the two sequence. Got? These problems you all have to do and you all have to solve in your notes. There is a 16 point. Draw the flow diagram for the 16 point radix 2 decimation in time FFT algorithms. Only the drawing it is. Only the flow diagram it is. So for 16, how many stages you will be having? You will be having 4 stages. One is 2 point, then 4 point, then 8 point, then 16 point. Okay. So this is first stage. This is second stage. This is third stage. And this is fourth stage. any doubts?